Thinking about the lost. I don't know that we have any lost, but if we did, the lost knows as soon as they come through that door what they're here for.
Yes.
Because the power of God sent them here, they wouldn't be here to begin with.
Come on.
They're under conviction. They want something. They want that love. They want that happiness. They want that contentment that you as a Christian have. And they wonder how to get it. And just as soon as they walk through that door, they're burdened down. And they want some answers. Now, we as ministers, we can stand up here and pound on them all day long and tell them you're going to go to hell and bust hell wide open. That's not going to help them. They already know that. They know that or they wouldn't be here. They wasn't afraid of God. They'd be somewhere doing dope or drugs or something. They want to change their lives. So tonight I'd like to ask you, when we leave, I won't be here long because I appreciate, I didn't figure you know anybody would be out tonight as cold as it is. So, appreciate you being here. And I want you to leave with that on your mind. If you know any loss,
amen.
Let's not try to put them down to love them.
Come on, man.
And they your love so bad. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, as I bow my head, Lord, before you, God, this evening, I thank you for the blessings of life. I thank you for loving us.
Amen.
I thank you for this congregation of brothers and sisters, Lord. And Lord, I ask you with all my heart that you might put the words in my mouth that might help somebody this evening, Lord, that might lighten somebody's load. It might brighten her day.
Mm-hmm.
God, it's been such a terrible, terrible week for a lot of people, Lord, but we always have you.
Amen.
We have you if we have nothing else. And God, I ask that you watch over and guide us.
Yes.
And that you'll help us. And Lord, all the ASD things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I remember when I first became a Christian about 16 years ago. And I've heard Brother Martin say this so many times. I want to save everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I came out there, man. I'd grab your hand and I'd grab take it off.
Amen.
Come on, let's go. Because I'm so full of the fire of the Holy Ghost. I want everybody to know about the Lord.
Amen.
But I didn't realize that all my old drinking buddies and all my brother buddies, they wasn't ready to meet the Lord. And they didn't want nothing to do with me.
Right.
And they stood in the background and they said, old Chuck will break down any day and we'll show him instead of him showing up.
Yeah.
Amen.
That's about 16 years ago.
Still there.
Still there.
All right. So, amen.
But do you know, and you probably know, but if you would backslide today, there would be somebody in the background say, I told you so. I knew all along. I knew all along that you could make it. 16 years. Some of you 20, 30, 40 years. But rest assured, if something would happen, there would be somebody out there to let you know.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Somebody.
Lord have mercy. I was on fire 16 years ago. I found out it's everything I could do to take care of, to save myself, you know. It's everything I could do to keep on the good side of God myself.
Yeah.
Much less telling everybody else what they were doing wrong.
Yeah.
I like to preach to myself a little while tonight because our pastor told us many times you can't point one finger that way unless you're pointing something back this way.
Amen.
But I've never felt the power of being able to say the things that I'm saying. Our God is a good God.
Yes.
He loves each and every one of us.
Yeah.
He said, I'll go with you all the way to the end of the world.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. What more do you want?
Amen.
But when I was saved, I did expect everybody. And I did. I expected everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Hey, you're going to do it. Let me tell you about the Lord.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so many people said, hey, you worry about you and I'll worry about me.
Yeah.
Well, that's cool.
Right. I used to do a song pertaining to that. If you don't mind, I'd like to do a little bit of it.
That's all right.
The love of God
surpasses
any other.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Surpasses any other. Can you imagine that?
Yes, it does.
I love my wife Brenda to death, but I can never love her the way God loves her.
Amen.
Right.
Surpasses all understanding.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes, Lord.
I was lost, but you knew where to find me.
All right.
I was hungry, you were bread for my soul. I was thirsty, and you gave living water.
Yes.
You were my shelter. When I had no place to go. That's why sometimes I just want to praise you.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes just to speak your name.
Oh, yes, Jesus.
Sometimes I just want to say thank you.
Thank you.
It's all right.
Without asking you for a thing.
Oh, yes.
Oh, sometimes I lift my hand to you.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
and sometimes right. all I do is cry.
Yes, Lord.
Everything that I have, I owe to you.
Amen.
Lord, in Calvary is a reason why. When I think of all the love you have given me, when I think of the price you paid for me, Lord, the trials of this earth, they seem as nothing. When compared to dark Calvary. And that's why sometimes I just want to praise you. Sometimes just to speak your name. Without asking you for a thing. Well, sometimes I lift my hand to you.
Yes, sir, Lord.
And sometimes all I do is cry.
Yes, Lord.
Everything that I have, I owe to you. Lord, in Calvary is the reason why.
It's all right.
Man. Calvary's the reason for
us. Oh, yeah.
Yes, yes.
As I was telling you, when I first got saved, I wanted to save everybody. It never did work out that way, and I soon found out that you got to wait upon the Lord.
Amen.
How many times have we read that in the scriptures? Wait.
Wait.
Scripture said, stand back, wait.
Wait.
What's the power of God?
Yes.
Stand back. Wait.
Yes.
Have you ever read the scriptures about the young man that David had gotten? We'll get into the lesson here in a minute. David had got the Ark of the Covenant and was bringing it back to Jerusalem. And they put it on this little old two-wheel cart. Mm-hmm. And God told them, said, so many feet stay back, stay away from the cart, stay away from the ark. Mm-hmm. Don't get close to it, and definitely don't touch it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, they were taken, and I can see them going down this little old grindy road, and the old two-wheel cart was wobbling, and the Ark of the Covenant started sliding. Mm-hmm. Or the scriptures started sliding, and they thought it was going to slide off. Young man ran up and he grabbed it with good intentions because he didn't want the Ark of the Covenant to slide off. You think he got him buried out of it? God slayed him. For the simple fact that he asked him to do something and he disobeyed him. See, sometimes in our life, when we want to talk to somebody, when we know that somebody is lost, and when we know that we can help them, or we think that we can help them, sometimes it's best to just stand back and watch God move.
Just
stand back and stay out of the way and let God do the work. But when you're new and on fire for the Lord, you won't say, Lord, you just get out of the way and let me have it, and I can show you how to do this. And God will give you so much rope to hang yourself. And then you say, young man, you get out of the way and I'll take care of everything that you have messed up.
Amen.
I have dear friends. I've had dear friends
yes.
that I wanted saved. I wanted them to feel the power of God the way I felt.
Yes.
I wanted them to see what God was doing for me that they could do for them.
Yes.
I knew in my heart that God could help them.
Yes.
But until they want the help, then I can do nothing for them.
Amen.
And their friends and neighbors, until we can get to them, God has got to get there first.
Man, that's good.
Right?
It took me a long time to figure that out.
Lord,
yes.
But I thought about the young man that wanted to save the Ark of the Covenant. My Lord, most precious thing on this earth is getting ready to fall and maybe be destroyed. I'm going to run up there and take care of it. Chapter 11 of the book of Matthew. Remember we were going to talk a little bit about the word seek? Looked it up a little bit. I'm no authority on any of this, so I want you to know that if you got any argument, argue with Google. According to Google, the word seek is in the Bible 244 times. And it's a Hebrew derivative of the word face. In other words, if you seek God, you want to face God. If you seek the scriptures, you want to face the scriptures. Verse 1, chapter 11 says, and then it came to pass when Jesus had made an end of commanding his 12 disciples, he departed thence to teach and to preach in their cities. And when John had heard in the prisons the works of Christ, he sent two of his disciples, and he said unto them, art thou he that should come? Or do we look for another? This, brothers and sisters, is the reason I don't know that I can go very long tonight. Because of the Holy Ghost power that the singing and the testimony of.
Praise God. Praise God.
Jesus is here. The Spirit of God is here.
Amen.
Come on. If you want fed, if you want your tank filled in the middle of the week, bless God, he'll fill it.
Yes.
If you want, that frown turned into a smile, bless God, he'll turn it.
Amen.
He's here, children. He's here for us.
Amen.
But you got to want it.
Amen.
Jesus answered and said unto them, go and show John again these things which you do hear and see. The blind receive their sight. The lame walk. The lepers are cleansed. The deaf hear. The dead are raised. More than anything else, and the poor have the gospel preached to them.
Yes, Lord.
And blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me. And as they departed, Jesus began to say unto the multitudes concerning John, what went ye out into the wilderness to see? Some refer to it as what seek ye? What do you want to face out in the wilderness? Do you know what you're asking for? Do you know what you're looking for? What went you out into the wilderness to see? A reed shaken with wind? Is that what you want to see? A reed shaken with wind? But what you went you out to see? A man clothed in soft raiment? Behold, they that wear soft clothing are in king's houses. What would you have to see?
Yes,
we went to a revival, I guess maybe last week, the man said, it's hard to be a Christian. And I pondered on that, brother. I pondered on that. In fact, I pondered all the way on. And you know what it is. It's hard to do the work of God. It's hard for a person in this day and time. It's hard not to get mad. It's hard not to want to hurt somebody for hurting somebody else. It's hard not to want to tell somebody that they're lying when you know they're lying. It's hard to be a Christian. It's hard to live to Christ's standards. But I believe that's the reason it's written in the scriptures that we all sin daily. Because we're not there yet. Come on. We're not there. I remember we were talking about when I was a young Christian and I was on fire for the Lord. I remembered that there was one thing that I wanted to do when I prayed. Foolishness, I prayed probably, but I prayed it anyway. I said, God, you know what I want to do one of these days? I want to come to the altar. I want to kneel down. God, I don't want to ask you for nothing.
My Lord.
That's just want to praise you.
All right.
Can I be good enough just to come to that altar
all
and
right.
just kneel down and Amen. Start praising and glorifying you and not say, God, will you help me with this?
Yep.
God, will you help
Amen.
Me with that?
Amen.
God, do you remember when I done this? God, when you
yep.
do that?
Yeah.
16 years ago, I ain't done it yet.
My
God. Here's a little secret. We're not going to do it.
My God.
We'll never live good enough. It's a continuous battle Amen. Every day.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
It's a continuous battle every day.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Lord.
Mm-hmm. Pastor preached. She couldn't go before the king because she was afraid of it. Because you had to call for an audience. You had to be asked to come before the king or you were subjected to being killed, slayed right there in front of him. That's a bad living. Ain't you glad today that you've got a king that will come to you? Ain't you glad today that you've got a king that will come in your heart anytime, any day, 365 days a year, day or night? A king of all kings.
Yes.
Ain't you glad of that?
Amen.
Can't you praise and glorify him?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Instead of saying, I can't go for this, and he might kill me if I don't have it. We have a king that will, he said, I'll stand at the door and knock, and if any man should answer, I will sup with him and he with me.
Amen.
Yes.
Yeah.
He will come in and sit down with you.
Yes, Lord.
Talk to you.
Yeah.
A king now. We're talking a king. We're not talking me or you or somebody up there down the road. We're talking about a king.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Don't that make you want to be shouting and happy about something in your life?
Amen.
Don't that make you want to say, hey, I've got something that nobody else has got?
Yes,
I've got a king. If I knock on the door, he will come.
Amen.
I've got a king. If I lay down on my pillow tonight, I'm going to say, Lord, I'm feeling bad.
Uh-huh.
I've got a king to come and sit right down there beside me and say, honey, baby.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Praise God.
You lay down and let me talk to you.
Thank you. Jesus.
And you let me take this dread away from you. Let me take this hurt away from you.
My
Lord.
Thank you.
Be here for you. Let me be here for you. How many kings do you know that will beg you to let me be here for you? You want to go to Iran or Iraq or some of these third world countries that has kings and walk up to them and say, I want you to do what I say for you to do. They'll cut your head off and hand it back to you before you hit the ground.
Amen.
I've got a king.
Praise God.
And on
tonight.
Yes. Thank you. I may look like a pauper. I may look like a nobody. Some people may think I'm a nobody. But I know that I know that I know.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Yes, not only God knows that he knows.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, yeah.
I've got a king for prophecies.
Yes.
I've got somebody that will be there when nobody else will.
Come on.
I've had a lot of people give up on them.
Yes,
yeah.
I've had a lot of people even today, they'll probably something that they tell you, man. Better watch. Tell them for me, if you don't mind, that, hey, they don't need to bother you. I'll tell you myself, and I'm not where I need to be. Tell them to save their time. Tell them to save their breath. That old Chuck is standing in front of you and say, I am not where I need to be. I'm not doing what I need to do. I'm not serving God the way I need to serve Him. I'm not the husband I need to be. I'm not the man I need to be. Because I can improve every day of my life. I can get better and better and better. So if somebody says, hey, you better watch old Chuck Martin and say, hey, if you done told me, you can just get on the way.
Yes, Lord.
I'd sit down and tell my God,
my God,
Father, I messed up. He said, I knew it before you did.
Hey.
Oh,
hard to be a Christian. It's easy when everything's going right.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, if I could stay in the sanctuary of the house of God 365 days a year, I'd be one of the best Christians God ever created. I paint that right now. If I could paint that right back in here and have you brothers and sisters every day right here, no problem.
Amen.
But I've got to go out those doors and out into this world.
Yeah. Amen.
That's what presents the problem. So if you're on top of the mountain, everything's all right. And one good thing about being down in Nevada, I've heard Brother Marvin say that's where the best soil's at. So if you want, you know, that's where the best dirt's at.
That's it.
Y'all watch it from top.
That's it.
So if you want to climb that hill, you got to start at the bottom.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. It's easy while you're on top of the mountain. Life is easy.
Come on.
When you're up on the mountain.
Bless Lord.
And you've got peace of mind like you've never known. But then things change and you're down in the valley. Don't lose faith, child, for you're never alone. For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. Things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the good times, He's still God in the valley. Of faith when you're up on that mountain.
Yes,
the talk comes easy when life's at its best. But it's down in that valley of trials and temptations. That's where faith is really put to the test. But the God on the mountain, He's still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the good times, He's still God in the bad times. God of the day, He's still God in the night. The songs have been sung and the testimony. How could you not believe that we got a God that loves you?
Amen.
Even here. God asked him, said, what are you seeking? What are you looking for? I thought some things I got to share with you.
Bless Lord.
Bless Jesus.
Luke 24:5. That's one sick. I'm going to scan them, trying to see what God would want us to share with us. Why seek ye the dead among the living?
Come on.
All right.
Why seek ye the dead? Remember, we were talking about the word seek or face? Mm-hmm. Why do you want to face death when life's here?
Come on.
Why do you want to put a frown on your face and say, woe is me, this is happening. I don't know if I'm ever going to get out of this. I don't know if I'm ever going to get out of that. Instead of putting a smile on your face and say, I am going to get out of this, I am going to get out of that, because God said I am going to get out of this, I am going to get out of that. God is here, and if God said it, it's true.
Come on now.
Why can't we do that? Why do we want to be like a dog or turn into its vomit? Why do we want to argue with God? Why do we want to say, God, I knew all along that you could take care of it after the circumstance, after it's over with? Why do we want to water in the mire and woe is me, and God take care of it, and then the next day stand up and say, I knew it. I knew God. I knew you there all along. I knew you'd take care of it. Why do we do that? faith comes easy on when you're talking about it.
Amen.
When you get down that valley, that faith gets a little thin.
Amen.
I think if we could share the reassurance that God gives us as Christians, if the lost and their family could see more of Christ in us,
come on.
I think that the altars would see a lot more people turn themselves over to God.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And as I said at the beginning, I'm preaching to you now. If I step on your toes, hey, sorry about that.
Right.
If I leave here, if I sit here and listen to the singing and the preaching and I praise and glorify God and I go home and some of my people come over and boy, here comes that old cousin of mine, I never could stand that rascal. And I put a big frown on my face and he comes in and I don't greet him the way he's supposed to be greeted and maybe he's lost. That ain't God like it.
Amen.
Amen.
Right. I think that's what God would want us to do. When 30 minutes before, I was here shaking hands with all your brothers and sisters, big smile on my face, everything. We was on top of that mountain then.
Amen.
Wasn't hard to shake hands with brother.
Amen.
Why can't we show more love?
That's
it. Is it that hard? Is it so hard that you can't? It's right there in your heart if you have Christ in you.
Amen.
He said, how can you say that you love me? You ain't saying. And hate your brother, you have saying. How can we do that? You think God just put that in there just to fill the page? Maybe there's a little spot there that needed filled in. They said, well, we'll just put that in there, just fill that in there.
Hey.
How can you love me who you've not seen and hate your brother that you have seen? That's the reason I look back to my 16 years and now I realize I'm not the Christian that I should be, need be, or ever have been. But there's room for improvement. And thank God that He's not gave up on me, and I'm not going to give up on me, because if I figure if God can stay with me, then I can put out the effort to stay with Himself.
Amen.
I learn things every day.
Yes.
And if I ever hurt any of you word-wise or anything, I'm sorry. But the fact remains that I can, and a lot of times I do. I say things that I shouldn't say and do things that I shouldn't do a lot of times. But there's no malice there. We'll turn it over more to stupidity than we do anything. Because I actually love everybody. There's not anybody that I don't love. I like what the pastor says when he leaves. I love you and ain't nothing to do about it. That's my slogan. I say that a lot anymore.
Amen.
I say that to the people, my family, and the people at stores. And it's just something that I've caught on doing it. It makes me feel good when I say it.
Yes.
Because after you say it a while, you begin to, it starts, gets up here and you start having more confidence in yourself and you can love everybody.
Yes.
But I'm telling you, who's sick you? Lord have mercy. We need to serve that King, and the only way that we can serve it is to show the lost how to serve it. A King that will come to you. Now you can walk up and you can tell a lost person that my father's a King and he owns the mountains, he owns the cattle of all thousand hills, and they won't think that you've lost, you're on your rocker.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Amen.
I remember I was lost, and there's no children here, so I won't present a bad example to them. But I had a rough weekend, and I was getting ready to go to work. And I remember to this day, I had a big Marlboro stuck in my mouth, and I was trying to lace up my work boot. And that Marlboro was going in my eye, and I had that hangover, and I felt so get rid of this habit.
All right.
I promise you that I will read those scriptures from this book.
Amen.
He did and I did.
Yes.
Right.
Threw those cigarettes away.
Mm-hmm.
If time and desire going, I'd grab that book and I'd read a chapter.
Yeah.
Bless the Lord.
But see, I didn't know what I was reading. After I became a Christian, I'd go back and, did I read that? I didn't read that. Because when you become a child of God, these words, they jump out at you.
Amen.
If you're lost, it's just another book.
Amen.
Yeah.
But if you're a child of God, you can read that scripture.
Yeah.
Verse 20, for example. For it is not ye that speak, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you.
Amen.
Well, I'll read that and they say, so what? But when I speak it, I know that the Spirit of God is in me.
Amen.
He can speak for me.
All right.
I could walk up to the lost and I'm like, why, let me show you something that will make you feel so much better. And if you wait on God, that's the reason I say if they come through those doors, we can beat on their heads with the Bible. We can thump on them all day long.
Yeah.
And if the God's not in it, they're not going to have it.
Amen.
Amen.
I heard a preacher say one time that I could get them to the altar with a hamburger, but the devil give them back two hot dogs. And it's about the truth.
Yeah.
True.
I heard another one say, when I give an altar call, it bothers me when I see, especially with young people, they'll come up the aisle and they'll be elbowing one another, popping bubbles with their bubble gum. I know that something's wrong there.
Amen.
But if God is in the equation, you don't have to say a lot.
Amen. True.
Just be there for them.
That's true.
Love them.
Amen.
But if they come through those doors, if you see a lost person come through those doors, you can say yours here real quick. God is knocking at their heart's door.
Amen. Right.
They may not get saved and they may not want to talk to you about it, but you can guarantee yourself that God is in the equation.
Amen.
And Lord, it's so good to see somebody turn their heart over to God. I know. See, if he can save me, and I know if some of you knew my past, and some of you probably do, you'd have to say, if God can save me, he can save anybody.
Amen.
Amen.
There's not a lot of not done. There's not a lot of not said. But if he can save me, which he has, we are thoughts of him, I think. They get back, I don't see all of them. But what? Regardless of what some people say. God loves me for what I am.
Oh, yeah. Amen.
I used to sing in a little quartet, and a girl, the lady would give her a testimony, and she'd start crying, and she'd say, can you believe it? God chose me. Out of all these people in this world,
my Lord.
God chose me to come in my heart.
Yes, Lord.
Don't you realize as Christian today that you have something
Bless
special?
Amen.
You have something Amen. That nobody can take away from you.
Right.
You
have something that's worth more than any gold that you can have.
Thank you, Lord.
Bless Lord.
Thank you.
You have a king that will come and sit with you and sit down to your bed and talk to you day and night. In
oh, yeah.
your own job, in the house,
Amen.
In the car.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Lord.
What a savior. What Savior we have.
Yes.
But I'm going to close because, like I said, I don't want to burden you all too long with that. The word seek. Remember that.
Amen.
Seek ye the kingdom of heaven.
Mm-hmm.
And all these other things are going to be. Seek ye the kingdom. Face the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Love you, then, the thing you can do about
it. All right.
I do, truly do. I thank you for putting up with me. I hope I've said something that might make you feel a little better.
Bless
I hope I've said something that will turn that frown into a smile.
All right.
I hope I've said something that might give you a little hope and a deal. But you know it in your heart already, don't you? Just like the lost know that they're not saved, then we know that we are. God bless you too.
I couldn't help but think about my Jeremiah 29:13.
Yeah.
You will seek for me and find me.
Yeah.
When you seek for me with all your heart, you'll face me.
Yeah.
When you face me, you'll find me. When you do it with all your heart.
Bless the Lord.
Lord have mercy. My God. What a time. What a time. What a time for us to just truly just see that. That's what God keeps saying to me. You can be. Seek for it. Thanks for it. And just keep dealing with me all the time. And I ain't there yet. Glory to God. I'm not there just like you are. I'm not there. Live with them. Find out. Amen. I am not there. But I'm seeking. I might work up, come on back, and lead us in a word of prayer. Because I definitely need it. Thank God. Anybody else want to come this off? Come on.
Just before we pray, like before you remember Christian James' family, he passed away, and Dorothy Phillips was down on you here, so we went to see her at the Turkey Conference, she passed away. So let's pray for those families.
Sister Tina said, for that emergency room, too. All come forward, don't you come and pray?
Precious Heavenly Father, Lord, as we bow our heads this glorious day that you've given us, God, giving you thanks and honor and glory to all that you've done for us, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that we might be able to seek your face. Thank you, Lord, that we might be able to look for you, Lord, that we might be able to guide towards you, Lord, that we might be able to say something to glorify your name. We ask, God, that you'll touch each and every soul here, Lord, at this altar. If they have a burden, Lord, that you might lift it. If they have a heartache, Lord, that you might cure it. God, we ask that you watch over and guide each and every one, Lord. We ask, Lord, that you'll touch us and watch over. Help us, Lord. Help us be more of a Christian. Help us be better people today. Help us be better people tomorrow than we are today. Help us, Lord, love one another. Show us, God, what it would take to love our enemies. Show us, Lord, what it would take to help the lost, to help somebody that's burdened down, Lord. Show us, Lord, how can we love a homeless person, Lord, for example. How can we love more in the nursing homes? How can we love our neighbors? God, would you touch us?
Yes,
would you help us, Lord? You know in our hearts that we're sincere, Lord.
Man.
You know that each and every soul here is sincere, Lord, wanting to glorify your name.
Oh, yes.
Wanting to praise you and want to lift you up. We want you to be proud of us, God.
Yeah.
We want to do something to glorify you. We want to do something where you can look down on us as you look down on Jesus and be proud, Lord, of what we do.
Man.
But Lord, would you help us?
Yes.
Would you, God? Would you touch us? And would you help the infirmity, the one that poured our burden down, the sickness, the sorrow? God, we know in our hearts, Lord.
Yes.
We know, Lord, we believe in healing. We believe in the healing power. We know, God, that you're the great doctor, that you're the doctor. Teach us the doctors, Lord. And we know, God, that you can help. You can help all of these things, Lord. But would you help us, God? Would you help us be better people? Lord, I could stay in. Lord, I could just praise and glorify you all day long. I would like to be able to just say, Lord, I just want to lift up my hands and praise you and somehow cry. As the song says, but Lord, I know that you're here with us, and that's the main thing. And God, we ask that you'll guide us and direct us and help us, Lord, for it's in the precious name of Jesus we pray.
Amen
and amen. Thank you, Jesus.